I think it's time we discuss the elephant in the room.
Ease up, mate. Ben hasn't put on that much weight.
I meant Ben's contract.
I'm very happy here.
At the moment.
At the moment.
Ben, this is the business. All right, tough negotiation. You got it?
Right. Mr. Hammond, I've sat on that side of the desk, and I know how it makes you feel. So, you write down how much you think Ben's worth. That's what we think of that. Hmm?
Wow, this is a community station. A family station, alright? There's no room for grandstanding.
Hey, do you want Ben to go the same way Rove did? You bungled him right out of this bloody station.
I wasn't even here when Rove was.
Hang on, let's talk about a compromise, hey?
Compromises are for losers, mate.
Are you a loser?
No.
Both of you get out. Ben, you're fired.
Fired?
Fired? Fired? You know what I think about you firing Ben, hey? This will do just nicely.
What happened to tough negotiations?
Shut up, mate, alright? Take what you can get. You're a loser.
Welcome to Live from St Kilda. Here's your host, Ben Murphy.
Good evening. Thanks for joining me. I am your host, Ben Murphy, and welcome to the best show on this channel, on this night, at this time slot. Yay! Thanks. I can't believe we're halfway through November already, and halfway through our season. Time flies. I actually said time flies to my nephew, who's rather literal. He pulled out his phone and opened his stopwatch and said, "Time flies? How do you do that? They move so quickly." Cute kid, not particularly bright. But we're nearing the end of the year, and everyone's already thinking about Christmas. My partner told me if I don't start showing them some more respect, I'll be singing a new Christmas classic this year, Single Bells. So I guess this prancer had better watch out. I've been prepping early and ordering gifts for everyone online. I've got to say, I can already tell that Australia Post is struggling under the pressure. This is a picture of how the Thermomix I bought my mother was delivered. Yikes. Which is a stark contrast to the way my bills arrive every month. Yeah, they always seem to arrive on time and in good condition. I do feel bad for the posties, though. I gave mine a big fright the other day. It's the only time I've seen him move quickly. What happened was, I went to the door naked. A simple mistake. We've all done it. But I'm not sure what scared him more, the fact that I was naked at the door or the fact that I knew where he lived. Maybe he was just expecting a larger package. Okay, tech crew, that is clearly not me. Like the audience would believe that. Looks nothing like me. Put me up. There we go. That's me. On tonight's show, we have former X Factor winner ISAIAH FIREBRACE, who made a huge impact on the world stage with his Eurovision entry song, Don't Come Easy, which I'm sure there is also a pill for. Well, I'm not sure, not me personally, but I've heard. ISAIAH was also the wizard on The Masked Singer a few years back. Very impressive. Dave Hughes was so close in working out who it was. He guessed Brad Pitt, George Clooney, Elton John, all people who no doubt line up begging to be on Australia's version of The Masked Singer. Yeah, right, Dave. Speaking of wizards, I bumped into Merlin the Wizard in the streets the other day. I know, very true. He wasn't looking so good, though. I guess being 4,000 years does that. He was barefoot, shirtless, and he had awful breath. I guess someone put a spell on him, as he was a super calloused, fragile mystic hexed by halitosis. Super calloused, fragile mystic hexed by halitosis. Never mind. Regardless of that wizard, wow, do we have a magic episode tonight. We've got music from Kai, along with James Ash, formerly the Rogue Traders. Yeah. A live performance from Party Mama and her dancers. We've got some random game show, as always, and our feature guest for Chit Chat that is the incredibly talented ISAIAH FIREBRACE here in studio. Yeah. So pop that phone on silent, crack open the drinks, and welcome to Live from St Kilda.
Woo-hoo! Hey man, it's time to hit the streets. It's St Kilda Beach.
Hot off the press, James Ash, the iconic Rogue Traders, has just released his original vocal house track titled Malibu Shadows. And James is here to tell us more about his freshest track yet. Hello, James!
Hey, Ben, thanks for having me. I really appreciate it. It's great to be on the show talking about my new track. Malibu Shadows, which was written in lockdown and is being released after lockdown. Couldn't work out any better. Hope this track gives people a little bit of joy and a little bit of heat on the dance floor. Cheers.
I'm sure it will. Let's check out that great new song now.
No one here to guide me. I gotta find my way. No one play the beat. I trust in the light. Just need to let go. Step out from the shadow. Don't you wanna step out from the dark to the light?
And that was Malibu Shadows. Such a great song, James. Thank you.
No problem, man. Thank you very much for having me. I really appreciate it. And looking forward to coming in and visiting you in the studio really soon. Cheers.
Oh, likewise. Cheers, James. Well, my summary, loose and the perfect soundtrack for your next beach road trip. The track is the pure embodiment of the upcoming hot season, minus the zupa dupas and unfortunate tan lines. Ouch.
It's time to play some random game show!
Yeah, that's right, my favourite part of the show. We're going to have a great game today called a movie mashup. But first, we're joined by two excellent, let's hope, contestants. Tony, who do we have?
Today's contestants are local lads Ben, we've got film student Angus, and practicing immunologist Brock.
Oh, make them feel welcome. Wow, practicing immunologist Rock, is that like spreading diseases or?
Hopefully containing them.
Containing them.
You never know really at this rate.
Oh, though you're quite young, you're probably spreading a few. It's all right, that's okay, behave yourself. And you're a film studio, so have you come here to play, have you come here to scope out the set?
Yeah, but I'm mainly here to beat him at this game.
Ah, you two know each other, friendly foes.
Yes.
Yeah, for now. Yeah.
Who's going to win between you two?
Me, 100%.
All right. Tony, what are we playing for today?
Today's champion will receive a $100 dinner voucher, Ben, thanks to our marvellous sponsor, Relax and Play, Melbourne's number one kids-friendly family entertainment centre.
Oh, that's right. A $100 voucher for Relax and Play. They have the best food in Melbourne. Over in Altona, be sure to check them out. Today, we're playing a movie mix-up. So I'm going to read out a title. The title's not quite right. The words mean the same, but they're incorrect. Person who gets the most amount of points in the amount of time wins. All right, if you get a question incorrect, point goes to the other person. Are you ready? Here we go. Question number one. Marvelous Miss. Yes. Angus.
Miss Marvel?
No. Originally a comic book superhero. It's Wonder Woman. All right, that's one for me, but I only got Xander in front of me. All right, question number two. A Return to Another Time. Yes.
Back to the future.
1 point for Angus. Very good. All right. The Unstable Scary Image Performance. I'll give you a clue. It's astounding, but time is fleeting. Oh. And mad. Yes, Angus.
The Rocky Horror Picture Show.
Correct. A point for Angus. Very good. How are you doing at home? All right. Does your buzzer work there, Rock?
Obviously.
Yep,
it does, yes.
Enthusiasm, maybe yes. Not. All right. Deceased author's camaraderie.
See, I know this, and I'll give you a chance. I'll give you a shot.
Deceased.
It's for $100. Take it. What is it?
Dead Poets Society.
Correct. All right, that's 3 points to Angus. All right, we're running out of time. Let's see if we go. Steel Fellow. Yeah, well, yes, Rock's in.
Iron Man.
Correct. Yay! Rock is on the board. Is it enough to win? Probably not. Mm. We're running out of time. Let's see how we go. Filthy Boogie. Yes.
Dirty Dancing.
Angus is a machine. He's killing it. All right. And finally, Vigilantes of the Milky Way. Oh, Rock, don't break the set.
Guardians of the Galaxy.
Yay! That's correct. That is Rock. But sadly, we are out of time. And Angus is our winner. Yay! $100 voucher going to Angus. Congratulations, boys. Still to come, a performance from Party Mama. And after the break, our chit-chat with guest ISAIAH FIREBRACE. Well, time to jump online and buy my mother-in-law a new gift. She said she wanted things for the bath and wasn't impressed with the toaster I got her. So here is your you go thing. The movie clue is a tree on some sand and a ball of some sort. Back soon. Congratulations, guys. Well, no luck getting a good gift from my mother-in-law. She didn't want that one-way ticket overseas either. Difficult. Did you solve the Hugo thing? The movie clue is a tree on some sand or something in a ball of some sort. It was, of course, Castaway. Wilson!
This is Chit Chat.
Our Chit Chat guest today first made an impression on Australian audiences as a bright-eyed 15-year-old on The X Factor, which he, of course, went on to win. Since then, he has competed on the global stage in Eurovision, become one of the world's most streamed First Nations artists, was the Wizard and the Masked Singer, featured in the AB series The School That Ended Racism, and he's back with a killer new hit, More Than Me. Please put your hands together for ISAIAH FIREBRACE! Hello,
Isaiah!
Thank you so much for joining us.
No worries.
Out of lockdown, how have your last few weeks been?
I've enjoyed the lockdown. I feel like I've had some time to like reset a bit and like have some me time. So I'm feeling really good.
Nice and relaxed. When the lockdown opened up and things like, did you go crazy shopping?
No. I've been out in regional Victoria, so I've just been like seriously like taking a break from like shopping and city life and the pace of it.
But you're starting to get busy again. Now, before we start talking about the incredible new song, I want to know something, because I get very hot under these studio lights.
Yes.
But you were on The Masked Singer as the Wizard.
Oh, yeah.
How hot and gross did that costume get?
Yeah, yeah, that's it there. I didn't know what to expect really going into it, but then when we had our outfit trying on the costume and I realized how heavy this thing was and how many layers, like it's like it shocked me. I was like, oh, I thought this was going to be easy, but it was pretty challenging, and having to like rest this massive wizard head like on me
and then sing
live,
well.
Like it wasn't pre-recorded. People think it's pre-recorded, but it's live, and holding the mic like here so it looks like it's like the wizard's mouth, and holding the staff, and like it was full on. It was honestly full on, but it was so fun. That experience was cool. I did it for fun, and I just enjoyed it.
Well, it seems that your last couple of years since you were 15 has been full on and a lot of fun, because you became quite well known and became sort of nationally famous rather quickly with The X Factor. How does a 15-year-old handle that instant fame?
To be honest, that's why I feel like this break in COVID was really, really good for me, because, like, since then, I was honestly working so much and time away from home and family, and, like, the break really gave me a moment to just, like, take it all in.
Yep.
And just to kind of have that me time. And, yeah, like, when, I won X Factor and went off to Eurovision, like, life was just going on and on and on so quickly. Like, I was just on this massive wave, and it was amazing. Like, it was the most exciting time of my life. But yeah, like, I felt like I really needed to take that step back, and now I feel really good. But even like looking back at this footage, I think, oh my gosh, like even the long hair and the hat and the... No, but it's...
You're going to miss that, because you've got long hair now, but in a couple of years, you'll start going grey like this fella just here.
Yeah, I shouldn't talk too early.
Because you were quite famous, you were quite young, and obviously a big fan favourite, especially for the people on TokTiks and Mediagrams and Facial Recognition Book and all that sort of stuff. I imagine you have some pretty hardcore fans. Did you get any particularly weird DMs or anything that you were like, oh, this, I'm not sure if this is for me?
No, I don't like to call my fans weird.
Has there been any that have maybe just crossed that line?
I remember signing this. This is one for the ladies. When you wear a bra, but you've got that squishy thing that, I don't know.
It's not just for ladies. It's for us middle-aged, overweight men.
Like,
too,
it's that squishy thing that you call a chicken breast or something. Is that right? A lady pulled that out and got me to sign it.
Wow.
So that was probably...
I'm assuming that was a bit before COVID, because now it would have been like...
Yeah, no, I would have been like Glenn 20 in that. No, but it was... That was a funny moment, yeah.
Well, there you go. If you want your chicken fillet signed, Isaiah's happy to sign them for you. After The X Factor, you then went on to Eurovision.
Yes.
Now, that must have been absolutely insane to be representing Australia's First Nations people on a complete global stage. Mm. How was that?
I just won X Factor, and then my life was just completely crazy. And then I get the call to do Eurovision. I'm just like, what is going on? Like, I couldn't believe it, and... I didn't really take notice of the pressure just because I was in it, you know, and I was just like doing it. I didn't realize, oh, this is like a nationwide media thing and everyone's like literally watching my every move. I didn't really notice that because I was just a deer in headlights, a young 17-year-old, you know, so I didn't really understand all of that. But the experience was honestly life-changing, and it was one of my biggest dreams, and I still can't believe that I got the chance to actually do it.
It's incredible that you you won X Factor, you got to achieve one of your biggest dreams of being on Eurovision, and now you're being a little bit greedy, and you're like, you know what, doing Eurovision once isn't enough. I'm
Don't
going back
say
to do
that,
it again.
I'm not greedy. No.
It's incredible. What's going on? You're part of the Australia Decides?
Yeah, so I'm a part of Eurovision Australia Decides next year in 2022. That's next
2022,
year.
2022,
yeah. On the Gold Coast. So this will be a bit different because when I obviously did Eurovision back then, there wasn't no selection thing like this. Like, you just got chosen, but now, like, you've got to vote. And I think I'm just, like, down for the ride. And, like,
so it doesn't stress you out that there's the voting and that, or you're just happy
to
go along and
like,
have a bit of fun?
I don't care, like, if I don't make it. I just want to be back on stage after, like, 2 years and just enjoy that moment. And I've got a really cool song that's actually a duet. My lips are sealed on the...
Yeah, because you have been teasing all your fans on your socials. You've been saying you can't tell us who the duet is. Mm. Now, you told me backstage it's Dave Hughes, which is... it's not Dave Hughes. Can you tell us who it is?
I can't say. I really want to say some stuff, but... You just have to wait. You're going to find out soon anyway. Like,
I've been thinking backstage and I'm thinking, you know what? It's possibly me. Because the crew here keep a lot of things away from me.
Well, you get too hot in light, so how are you going to handle Eurovision?
Yeah, well, that's very true. I think I'll do okay. Well, give me a little... What could I sing to... if I was, like, trying to... Okay, hey, I want to do a duet with you. What's something that I could do to show you that I'm a good singer? Could you teach me a note or something along those lines?
Yeah, you can start there. Oh, you got good pitch.
Hang on. Just pull this up a little bit.
Yeah, you might.
Oh, I'm so sorry to those people with cats who have just their cats and dogs have gone absolutely wild. Now, you do have an incredibly brand new song out.
More Than Me. Yes, this is my latest song that's out, and I worked on this one when things were open and I was over in LA, and I haven't released like a power ballad like this since. I think it actually was since Eurovision with Don't Come Easy.
Yeah.
So I felt like it was the right time to release a song like this, and it's a song that I'm really personally connected to. And
because it's about heartbreak, isn't it?
Yeah, for sure, yeah.
So is that going to be then quite emotionally challenging for you to get up and sing a beautiful song like this, but with a personal message?
Well, I'm glad I'm over the heartbreak, so that helps. But with just like writing and releasing songs, I always love to have songs that I can connect to on that level. I don't know, I hope, I won't get too emotional, but definitely like when I've had input into the songs and their real stories, like, definitely makes the performance more real.
Yeah. Well, you know what? Let's take a look at More Than Me now from ISAIAH FIREBRACE. Here it is. If you want to change your mind, come back to me, I'll forget this all happened. I promise I'll love you. Ooh, I'll always love you. I've been trying to leave. Song.
That's not the Eurovision song.
Well, you know what? It's got winner already all over it. It's an absolutely incredible song.
Oh,
congratulations to the... Now that sound means it's time to play a this or that. 60 seconds are going to go on the clock. You have to answer as many this or that questions as you can without that time. I'm going to give you two answers to choose from. You have to choose one, hence this or that. ISAIAH, are you ready?
I'm nervous. Okay.
All right, Toby, your time starts now. Texting or talking?
Texting.
X Factor or Eurovision?
Eurovision.
TikTok or Instagram?
TikTok.
Collaboration or solo?
Collaboration.
Long hair or the new short hair?
Oh my god, short hair.
It's a bit cooler, isn't it? Who is nicest, Denny Minogue, Guy Sebastian or James Blunt?
This, that or the other though.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
I would say Guy's pretty good.
Dawn or dusk?
Dusk.
Beer or coffee?
I love coffee and beer.
not together, right? That's pretty gross. Cash or card?
Cash.
And as much as we love it, and that Eurovision's in, Australia's in Eurovision, does it make sense to you? It's a bit strange. That's great.
I have to say yes, so yes.
And finally, should everyone stream your latest single, More Than Me?
Yes,
now?
Everyone go check it out, please.
More Than Me is out now. Be sure to check it out. A big round of applause for ISAIAH FIREBRACE, ladies and gentlemen. Be sure to follow him on the socials. Still to come, a live performance from Party Mama, but here is your Hugo Think movie clue. An alien, a phone, and a house. Now time to see what my ex is up to on Facebook. Back soon. Of my ex on social media, they've really let themselves go. What a relief. Your clue was an alien, a phone, and a house. How easy was that one? It was, of course, Titanic. Now, I'm sure we all have incredibly amazing... Hello? E.T.? Ah, sorry, it was E.T., not Titanic. had you all going. It's not like I made that mistake. Ugh. Anyway, I'm sure we all have some amazing stories about our neighbours, but when it comes to being nice, this helpful group can't be beat. Danielle was so in love with her two-storey biscuit box house that she decided to move her house across the river, as you can see here. Hang on a second. Is that house sinking? Yes, it says right here, the house then began to sink. But before all was lost, a fleet of local lake locomotives launched a last-minute rescue mission. Local lake locomotives launched... Oh, my gosh, whoever wrote that should be fired. Get out. Anyway, they launched a last-minute rescue mission to ensure the house was successfully relocated to land. I guess it shows that with enough help, our dreams can not only come true, but they can float too. Speaking of floating, in conservation news, over 9,000 kilograms of trash have been removed from the Pacific Ocean. This cleaning operation, known as System 002, has the giant job of tackling over 1.8 trillion pieces of plastic polluting the water, and it aims to remove most, if not all, of the oceanic garbage by 2040. 10 years ago, the creator Boyan Slat was told he would never be able to clean these garbage patches. However, with a little hard work, he proved them wrong. He developed a system that literally drags a giant net between two boats in a U formation, gathering and collecting trash for offshore recycling. I guess this goes to show that with a little hard work, you can do anything. Finally, let's take a look at a talented pottery kitten. This little artist has more precision in her tiny paws than most people do in their whole body. You know, when I think of pottery, all I can imagine is that scene in Ghosts. You know the one with the music and the two people making clay, if you know what I mean? It's now that part of the show we all love because we get to see some incredible variety performers in and around Melbourne and Australia. And do we have a treat for you today? So pop on your dancing shoes and get ready to have a boogie. And please welcome Nessie from Party Mama! Hey! Hello,
Nessie! Hello!
Look at you looking so festive!
Tajay.
Oh, Tajay. Well, this is Armani, Salvation Armani.
Yes, very impressive.
It's not bad, is it? We could go out and have a bit of a thrift shop boogie. So what are we doing today? We're doing some cooking, making some salsa?
No, we're going to perform the Party Mama and the Babe style.
Oh, do you need an extra babe?
I might at the end, we'll see.
All right, I'm going to let you get rid of Nessie. You at home, you are ready for a treat. So sit back, relax, and please put your hands together for Party Mama and the Babes!
Are you ready to party with Ben Murphy Live?
Yeah!
Let's make some noise! Her name was Lola, she was a showgirl. But that was 30 years ago when we used to have a show. Now it's a disco, but not for Lola. Faded feathers in her hair and it just got down to where she sat. So we fight, she dragged herself half down. She lost to you, she lost Tony. Lost her mind at the Copa, Copacabana. Tell me how I make my name. write it down. Let's get loud. Let's get loud.
Socials. Be sure to check her out. A big round of applause for all of our guests tonight performing in studio. And a huge thanks to ISAIAH FIREBRACE. We wish him well for Eurovision. We'll be back next week with more live from St Kilda. Bye-bye! At the Cobra Cabana.